distant star. They named it Hellion.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back. This is another episode of Hellion. We're going to be doing a long-term playthrough building while on the air with this on it. We had a base that was a little bit expanded on it. It was with me and another person. We had not set up any kind of recording for it or anything like that. But he lost the ship at some point. So we are going to do more of a solo for this on it and see how far we can get as a solo player. So we are coming out of our cryopod. And let us start everything. This is mainly going to be a long term, like I said, so we're gonna try to expand our base on it and see what we can get. But first, before anything, dear devs, please make a tiny little dot of where I'm looking. Okay, so we're gonna do that, and we're gonna do our little alt tab thing real quick, because there we go, all fixed. I swear, multi-monitors means multi-problems. Hellion does not cooperate very well. Every time I start it up, it kind of counts my mouse as somewhere else, so it doesn't actually, as soon as I click up to like top left, it just basically minimizes my thing. So let's get all our stuff on. Okay, grab this here. Let's get some med packs. Expand upon this a little bit in case we need them. Let's get our power on and head out. Grab our docking bay, and we are going to our airlock and expand on that. Optimum, nice. Okay. Let's go outside of here. SOS. You're on your own, sucker! Okay. And we are going to close this also because we are going to use a docking mechanism for this. Alright, so here we are. Alright, there's our ship and there's our docking module. So let us go get that docking module as quickly as we can and get the basics of everything set up. And then that way we can kind of do more of the fun stuff like exploration and trying to take things from other people. Not going to really do much mining on it. There's not really a purpose to it. Even though you can get fuel for your ship, it doesn't really seem to be that important at this point in time. So we'll whip around and find our... There it is. Come in there, slow it down a little bit so we don't just slam into it. As we always say, our face is not our feet. Okay, let us look around here and see if we can't find our ship and all of this. Oh, what was that? Oh, there we go. There's something. So we got a good reference point right there. Okay, so for ships there, that means our dock should be somewhere around there. Hopefully. Planet. Wait, we saw something down this way. There we go. There it is. Alright, so let us start heading there. We are on a Dallas server just because there's a lot more orbiting structures left over from people, and so that also means though with it comes the Dallas lag and Dallas latency. Oh my god, there it is right there. Okay, hopefully we can get back to what we were looking at. I swear the Dallas servers are just atrocious. There we go. It's just bobbing around everywhere, even though I'm not really doing much. Okay. Let's get this going. Okay, so eventually at some point we will actually rotate around this. Just we're going to use this view for now. So. Okay, so this is a good part to do it. So let's get the rotation going. Should see it, there we go. Okay, we're basically coming up from underneath it, so we're gonna have to flip this around slightly. Okay, slow ourselves down a little bit on a Dallas server. So the RCS, I noticed, I don't know if they pushed out something on it, is actually stopping my roll, which is making life easy, but I don't remember it necessarily stopping that. It would stop my looking rotation, but never anything like that. Okay, so let us get this in there. Should be pretty lined up. Shouldn't have to do much. Okay, let's line this up a little bit better. Okay, we should be just fine for that lineup. There we go. Alright, so now we've got this on there. Let's close this. And we're mainly just going to take the longer spacesuit. Shoo. Okay, depressurize this. Although I did notice kind of like a cheater method. You could go through the air vents down there and get into that room. I guess it's depressurized. Oops, we didn't want to depressurize. Let's repressurize that. Okay. Take our mask off. So that's exactly what we wanted to do. You can't have any items on you when you want to take off your suit here. put things back to in case we need them for later. We have everything that we really need right now, so let us close this door and head to our ship, and we're going to start looking for another airlock. Okay, let's get that depressurized. Pressure hazard, no more. Okay, ship's right in front of us. Nice. Nice, nice. Slow ourselves down. Here we go. We gotta get to the other side. Touch of that Dallas lag. Okay, depressurize this. Oh man, we gotta play the click game again? Oh, this is my favorite game. Are we gonna continue through? Nice. It's like I pumped it. As you notice, this is probably my least favorite part of all of this, is the just waiting for the depressurization. I just feel like it takes a little too long. Like, I get the point, and I'm all for that immersion, but come on. Twice as fast would be nice. It's not like we really have a pressure and depressure system that we can really use as a reference, so make it twice as fast. Trust me, I'll believe you. I'll believe that's how it's supposed to be in life. Makeshift coaster right there. Nice. It's like a rubber. Okay, get out of here. Take off the helmet. Oh, that's right. I have the... So this helmet doesn't really go up or down. It's a little depressing. I'm assuming it's not using oxygen. Assuming. Okay. Going in. Face. Alright. Let us deal with a few things real quick involving going down. We're going to refill our RCS right now before we take off. That way we don't have to do it mid-flight in case we're trying to do something. Okay, so RCS. We're going to go down here. Let's fill this up. Look at all that nitrogen. Ooh, it's a lot of tritium. Pretty good start to it. Yeah, we're all filled up. Yep, got all that. Let's just see our warp cores. I'm always interested for that. That's bad. Especially if we're looking at a long-term play. Hopefully we got some good ones inside of it. Alright, let's deal with our power. So let's get our solar panels 1 and 2 up. Okay, optimal. Let's get our capacitor on. Let's turn this one off. I don't know if we'll necessarily need it right now. I might have to come back here and turn it on, especially once I rotate around. I might need to. Oh, hell no. Get off my ship! This is an object that you can interact with on their stations, but just not on this boat. Don't know why. Let's see what we got. We only got one really good one, so we're kind of kind of low on warp cores if we're looking for a long term, especially if we have to go to a different system. As for objects around us, there's another object 8.8 away, so we might deal with that real quick. Actually, there's something 2.8 out. I might bump it to push it out of orbit too, just to make my life easier when it comes down to coming back home. If I bump it out of orbit, it won't be something, another object that's there trying to interfere with me clicking on home station, and then I'm going to end up warping to that. Now let's get a little bit of speed. A little impatient on this. Okay, so here's our object. This should be pretty good. It looks like a repairing structure. Let's get in there a little bit. Let's slow ourselves down. That match velocity is quite incorrect though. It's kind of like the best we're gonna get. We're just gonna have to try to go quicker. There we go. That is as good as we're gonna get. It's moving slowly away from us, so we gotta go now. Alright, we're gonna depressurize that bottom cabin too, because I don't like having to always go through that pod up top. So we'll take this with us too, because that's gonna disappear. Oh, whoa. Almost forgot. So life support. We're gonna make sure to turn off the cargo bay. There we go. Okay, cargo bay. Actually, we are going to take our old suit with us. And that's mainly in case we find another good one, we can try to swap it out and bring a better one back. Ooh. I didn't know that the larger one can hold more packs. That's nice. So we're gonna take this off here, stick that there. Okay, down we go. Or up it comes, I guess. Oh, nope, down we go. Okay, that can go there. Let us pop this door. Let's close this just because it has some pressure in it. That way, because what's going to happen is if we depressurize that and we come back in, it's going to make things a little bit more complicated. So let's open that up and back up. Or let's do nothing. Yeah, get out of there, object. We do not like those. Okay, so it was on the front of our ship. We were facing it. So it is traveling away from us slightly. It's up to us to try to... Oh, boy. That's what happens when you wait, like, 3-4 minutes. Even a little bit of speed will become a big distance. I just hope I can repair these at some point. Because these would be nice to have. Glowing stuff in here. That's a very good module. Okay, so let us take that, because that looks pretty good. We'll take the cargo container, because cargo containers are useful. What do we got? No weapons. Let's barrel roll around. What do we got here? Looks like some ammo up here. Hacking tool, sure, why not? Ammo's always useful. Anything good in there? We've got a... air filter unit, sure. Okay, so everything back here has been dealt with. Should be more over here. Jeez, I'm all over the place today. Okay, so we got a rifle now. And a better suit there. Let's look around here else. Before we take that, since we can't add that to inventory. I think that is it. That was my last peruse. It just seems like it's always just these objects here. Okay, since we're here, we might as well. Go. Fresh pack. Oh. I'm so excited to get out of here. Jeez. Confined spaces. There's our ship. Let's head back. So, I mean, we got a few parts, nothing over the top by any means. And we'll test out that other object out there further. We're gonna bump this out of orbit too, so that it finds its own orbit. In we go. Okay, we'll get this door closed. Okay, and let's deal with this. So we've got some ammunition that's going to go up top, but mainly things like this. Those are in there, so let's find one that's kind of bad and stick that one in it instead. And then whenever we get ready to leave, we'll just have that there too. Be disposed of. Yeah. Okay. Close this. That's not the air filters one. I guess we could see here since I have one on hand. Does this one need to be replaced? It does. So we'll just deal with that. There you go. That battery's pretty bad. We'll grab a battery for that. That one's pretty, pretty bad. Okay, and that unit's fully repaired, even though we're actually never gonna pretty much use it, but it's been handled, I guess. Take that with us. I can go with the others. Pressurizing. Dang, those things take forever. While we do that, might as well refill this up again. So much pressurizing and depressurizing that it's a pain in the butt. Okay, we're just about there at the 0.9 marker, and then we can start to go up. And those will not work with the rest of those suits, but I'd rather get some upgraded parts on it instead of having a bunch of useless things. Okay, reload that, stick that back on there. I usually like to have a little bit of ammunition in these things. Helps just kind of reduce the amount of things that we can actually hold. So we'll put that in there. Let's take a seat. All right, so our object's pretty close still. Dallas lag again. All right. Do 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 do. Okay, approaching it quick on purpose. Get a little extra speed. There we go. Now that thing should have no feel, so hopefully, as you can see, it's moving pretty quick now. I'm actually, I think, chasing it, and still it's outrunning me. So in theory, I should be negative. So that thing is hauling away from me. So that's a good thing. Let's see its orbit. I wonder if it's changed. Okay, let's see our home station. It should just get us right where we are. There we are. All right, so here's our home station now. Let's get that unclicked. So it doesn't look like it's changed its orbit, really, but it isn't part of our orbit. Let's go back to our home station again and take a look on it. Sadly, with this one here, I think this is where I was last time. There is no orbiting bodies that I was able to ever find besides... Oh, no, there's orbiting bodies. Probably just asteroids, though. Yeah, they're just asteroids. Home station again. It shows all the orbiting bodies, so there's a lot of them. It's just... not showing them. Let's get this out of the way. Let's try pushing some buttons here and seeing if it will allow us to activate. No, it's trying to talk to people. And that was after the Y, so... That thing has gotten some distance from us. Okay. Okay, we're gonna get going to that one there too. After this, what we're gonna probably attempt to do is kind of just log out, log back in, see if we can't get the contacts to show up for orbiting. It kind of shows you, like, when you zoom in for a second, that there's a bunch of orbiting structures, but I can't really see them. It doesn't show them, as you can see too. Okay, this is no. We need to go a lot faster than this. Okay, we're gonna get that moving over to that. Get a little bit more intense that way. Alright, we're gonna get a lot more speed. That's it. Ooh, 101, 102. Okay. We're really moving. Alright, we're gonna start a process of slowing down. This would probably be a lot easier if we actually had engines. Ooh, okay. And I think we're hitting the lag too, because I can't alter, yeah, I can't churn and all that, so what's gonna happen is it's gonna catch up and make me go like... Yep, there we go. Okay, let's see here. We're gonna get inside of this range.
Or
double L.
I have a cat that's deciding he wants to try to eat plastic.
Not a good choice.
What?
Yeah, I know. Plastic, not edible. Grabbing a rubber glove and trying to pull that out of your butt.
And you'll just be like,
trying to poop it out. Okay, we are just about there. It's probably, I'm assuming, one of those hatches on it, which had some pretty good stuff last time we went to one on it.
It had some things involving a hacking tool on it, so.
Okay, just about there. Okay, we're pretty much matched for it, but I have a feeling the Dallas is doing the lag again. There we go. Okay, we're gonna go like that. Good enough. Let's get out of the seat. Let's go see. Depressurize again. So much depressurizing and repressurizing in this game. Okay, so imagine the halfway point would be like right here. We should have just enough oxygen to get there and back, so. Okay, what are you up there floating? Hacking tools? Oh, just kidding. Oh, batteries. Okay, so we've got some good stuff in here. It's another... Okay, so what type of suit, though, is this? It's the one that I'm wearing. So we're gonna put this down here. We're gonna kind of follow that one. Oh. There we go, I got some oxygen back. As you notice, that doesn't really kill you. There's a limited amount of oxygen you have. So you don't have to worry as much about dying to that kind of stuff. Now, don't get me wrong, I was a little worried. I'd be like, oh man, what happens if I don't reach this? My longevity. Playthrough over. Hey. Okay, so everything else we have. Ooh, that's what I was looking for. Okay, so we got something good out of that. Alright, so... I think we'll be back. I don't know if that's really what I think it is. No, the weapon's in my hand, supposedly. Maybe if I put that down there, and then... There we go, ammunition on it. It's saying that it's like a full-on weapon. Alright, where is our cool backpack so we can get out of here? Ah, there it is. Alright, we're gonna bring these back. There's some nicer items in there, too, for the other stuff. So that's kind of what we want to get. We just gotta kind of relocate the ship. There it is. And so how we're gonna kind of do that is we're just gonna bring over the stuff, and we're gonna hang this up, and then I'll grab the next piece and then come up. Because I should only need the helmet for the most part. Okay, let's go in. Rotate in. Going quick again, so we're gonna try to do is grab a helmet at least. Ooh, let's slow down. We're gonna get near the object but not actually hit it, and we're gonna use the RCS to try to see if we can't grip without necessarily hitting it. There we go. All right, so we've got one of those. You know what, we could fit another. And then that one we'll actually have on hand. If I remember correctly, I threw some of these ammo clips around. So, let us take this. Guess not that one. I guess this one? There we go, we got some ammo in there for that one. Here's a spare ammo. And then this we'll put back. Make some extra strips. And then once we're done with this, we're also gonna bump that into space too. There we go. And we'll go into this one again. let's go up. We're just kind of a test too at the same time. Oh, yep, nope, stays on. Okay, so we've got a full complement of those there. Alright, so we got a railgun, and now we have a sniper here too, another railgun. Let's go in here too. I think this is the one that we need. Nope, this is not the one we need. These are not the droids we are looking for on that one. Okay, so here it is. On it. Power. Auto? So surprisingly, once you put a clip in, I guess it's kind of just done. I wonder if these will fit in that. They do. Nice. And this is the military assault rifle gun. What ammo is this? So it's a sniper. I don't think it will actually reload itself. Yeah, no. We have some ammunition, but it's not for that one. Okay. Well, we're not going to get too ADD about it, I guess, because I guess we don't really have a choice. Alright, close that. Let's go up again, actually. We're going to look into converting over to one of the normal suits. The bigger ones. Oops! Didn't want to hit escape. Oh, it's doing the lag thing for it. There it goes. This is just my pile of junk here. This is my junk pile growing. Do do do. Okay, it should be everything. Oh, we got, that's right, we got hacking tools. Still don't know what the heck these all do necessarily. Whatever, we have them. We'll put them in this corner. This corner will be our hacking corner of uselessness. But we have them! Okay, now we should be able to remove this, add this to our junk pile. And we are going to get a full complement of the newer stuff. And we're gonna just go get the other two things for it. The other helmet, I think it was, and the yeah, I think it was just a helmet. So we're going to get the helmet. That way we're kind of moving along with getting these things. So let's depressurize this. And then we're going to try to re-log into this server. Because what I'm trying to find is other people's modules, dock up to them, and start taking their resources for that. Okay, close this. It's probably pretty far out there now. Ooh my god. Gonna do the thing before, we're just gonna kind of full hold down it. We should be cruising, and what we're gonna do is just get near it and then RCS it. Because if you hit the object, you know, you'll take damage, but technically if you RCS and grip with your, like, your shoulder or your arm on the side, you'll take no damage. Cool, we got to kind of touch it ever so slightly, so we were able to slow down a lot. Interesting that there's a docking. This isn't complete, so... Does this already have stuff in it now? That's just a normal pack. It's back up, whoop around. Head back with the helmet at least, that way we're down one more object to have the good long ones on it. I kind of wish I had some extra, like, space for suits on that ship. That way I could take more back to the main base. Or in this case, the nightclub! So our last task after this, once we get up and running, is going to be the fact that we need to knock that object out of orbit. Something floating up at the top right of my screen. It's probably that dock. Hair there for a second. All right, we are done at this thing. We took everything of use off of it. OCD, OCD. Okay, repressurizing again. Good time for another drink.
Excuse me, junk pile, you're in the way. This object. Okay, so that object is just going and gone. You can see it down there. Okay, we're gonna stand up here because we are going to log out of this real quick. I think I'll count that as the end of this episode for this Let's Play of Hellion on it. More of a prolonged gameplay on it. I will immediately start rolling number two, but it's a good point to kind of just stop and get this one uploaded from there. So if you guys watch this, thank you for watching on it, and I'll see you on the next one.